Happy Saturday. It's already 4. I don't know if you can tell, but it's a little dark and gloomy. I have gone out to breakfast, or brunch really, and I was working on this crochet square. There, all I could find was a video for it, so I was watching the video and writing it down because I prefer written instructions. And then I was modifying it a bit so that the back looked better and to make it into a granny cluster rose on the outer rows so I could make it match up with these 10-inch squares that we do. It's a lot of work though. I'll have to do another one and see how fast it goes. But it's almost done, but I heard drama outside on the camera. The boys on our street are once again hating on Sebastian, and even more they're hating on me because I call them out for it. They now say mean things about me on the bus to Sebastian. And I'm pretty much bullying him. So if it gets any worse, I might have to mention it to the guidance counselor. Like if it gets to the point where the bus is a risky situation for arguments to break out. I don't know, I hate it. I hate it. And they just hate me because if I hear things that come out and ask if there's a problem, I didn't even have to. I just came out and stood there and they just stopped calling him a brat and walked away. Probably saying how much of a B word I am. Not that they say that, they say idiot. Which, it's adorable. Sebastian's good friend. I'm so afraid to even repeat that word. I was like, you can say it once. And he was like telling us what was going on. So we talked a lot, Sebastian and I and his friend, his sweet friend. And we talked about how bullies are feeling hurt about something and they want to make other people feel hurt to make themselves feel better. And well, the friend is free to choose who he plays with and be friends with. You should consider playing with people you know are always kind, but ultimately it's up to you. So I don't know. I don't like it. I don't like it. I don't like it. I wish they would all move away, all the bad ones. I don't understand why they're like this. And I know Sebastian didn't help the situation when we had the snowman incident and he blamed two of them because he wouldn't tell me who he really was with, because I did reach out to a mom and I didn't full-on say I believe it's your son. I was like, I'm so confused, this is what he's telling me, but I don't understand, can you help me work through this? And ultimately I told her he never did say, but we think we know who it is, and they think it's because he's not allowed to play with his kid. Thank you for talking to me about this, I appreciate it. So I don't know. I don't know if she ever talked to her son about it beyond when she said she initially saw the post about the snowman and asked him. So I don't know if that actually made it worse or if it's just one of those things. But I was gonna braid, but then that took a while, and now it's 4:20, and I don't know if I want to. I don't want to, but. I should make myself. I'm kind of shaky from coffee this morning, but I'll make myself do a little bit and we'll see. I always settle into it. I really need to. My hair's a ratty mess. Okay, rant is over. is bedtime. My bangs are blue. A little bit of fading where I put some conditioner to blend it out, but yeah, I tried a little bit for the after my bath, but that was wonderful and hot and sweaty. Anyway, what did we do? What did we do? I did some crochet. I did some braiding, not too much, but I did a few here and a couple there. Not too much because I was also dyeing my bangs. But we made a little bit of progress, which is progress. And then I stopped and we went out for pizza, which I didn't film. Danny did not want to have to come get it, and we didn't want to deliver and have it be cold and soggy. So we went there and then came home. I had a bath. It's bedtime, and yeah, it's pretty late. I let him stay up, and then I got an email from work saying they were editing a page and it got all hosed, so I was just writing them back on how to get to their past revisions. And yeah, now I'm gonna get Sebastian to bed, but the blanket is coming along, the donation one. I think I've decided it's probably just gonna be a white border. I might have to order some more white. I'm using two different whites. One is shinier, which is inside the squares, and this one is thinner and matte. So I might actually use both if I have enough of this thinner one to do a final border around everything, but have like a thicker white border. But I really wanted to learn this one and write it all down. Everybody has video tutorials. I did change it. The way this purple is done is you have these loose chains of purple going behind the petal, and I ended up covering them up with the stitch, like wrapping the stitch around them so you only see where it's in between. And then when I got to this one, I did leave that one out because you have to actually attach the purple to it in order to have this little petal that sticks up 3D. I really like it. I was gonna start another one where the pink and yellow are opposite and consider making my next donation blanket BBs. I would have to order more of this purple and yellow, which are both cheap Walmart. The pink is a little more expensive and a lot nicer, but it is just a Michaels exclusive brand. So I might need another one of those from Michaels. And then I'd probably choose one or two more colors of this Walmart. And I would do some solid and some daisy, because I think it would take a little while. But again, I wanted to see how long it takes to make one when I'm not watching her video, which I had to speed up to 1.5 speed because she talks so slow. I'm like, come on, what's the next step? And then I'd have to pause it and write each step down in notes for myself. But I like it. I also took it back a few times when I realized that those strands were going to be in the back. I was like, no, 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 we don't want fingers caught. So I'm happy with it. And that was a good adventure. And I wonder if it would be cute on a sweater. It would certainly be cute on a bag. So that's another possibility of what I could make out of this. A cute little bag. A strap. How much would you pay for a bag like that? Crochet can't be priced high enough to make a profit unless you get a good following who's willing to pay premium prices, because say that's like $10 of supplies, it'll be, a bag would be And I'm like 10 hours of work. That's
my. Oh, I only have mine.
Well, the gummies are too hard until Daddy goes to Costco. You probably don't want them.
Yeah.
I mean, I still have some, but they're just rocks at this point. Anyway, I haven't done anything on this thing, but I'll work on it at some point. I don't know. Anyway, I'm gonna get him to bed because it's after 9, and then I'll choose what I'm gonna do. I, of course, have this that I'm working on for myself, but that's kind of like a long-term project. That could be months. I could even bring that on our trip to California, because I feel like I could pack some small balls and work on squares on the plane and just pack everything flat in my suitcase. And in the winter, I drink decaf hot tea most of the day because I'm cold. And then after my bath, I'm nice and hot. So starting a dinner like right before my bath, it's nice start chugging lots of water. Anyway, I'm gonna go. Good night. Stay safe. Be kind. And don't forget, wash your hands.